Bojogin was composed by, in 1969 by Nomura Seijo. This piece was written by Seijo. He was inspired by a 3rd-century Chinese poem describing the ties between an army general and the emperor, both of whom had dedicated their lives to statecraft and just government. Nomura was so moved by this poem that he composed Gojogen to convey the pathos of the final battle for the mortally ill general and his troops. Gojogen is the name of the battlefield where the battle took place. The melody incorporates elements of military marches and old folk tunes to convey the spirit of the moment leading up to the battle. The refrain, Josho Yamai Atsukariki, refers to the general's worsening condition as the battle approaches. You'll see we've got a lot of kotos set up here on stage, as well as our piano and a taiko drum. We are being joined today for this particular piece by a number of guest musicians. Dr. Hunter, our vocalist who was here earlier for Henso Kyoku Sakura Sakura, will be joining us on female vocal, joined by the Reverend Nick Nishio on male vocal. We will be joined by 2 graduates of the University of Maryland Japanese Koto Ensemble, Tom Este on the drum and Sarah Hess on piano. We will be joined by graduate student Donnie Scali on the contrabass and by Mary Josie Blanchard and Yuriko Gandolfo on the flute. One will be playing the shakuhachi part and the other will be playing the regular Western flute part. This is a very dynamic, interesting piece that will be very, very different from the other pieces you've heard today. It's got a lot of energy, a lot of vibrancy. It is a really wonderful piece. So we will get started in just a moment.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. The koto is a very traditional instrument of Japan. It's recognized as one of the most distinctive sounds in Japanese music. The koto itself is about 6 feet long. It has 13 strings and is made out of polonium, which is a light tone wood that is native to China, Laos, Vietnam, parts of North America, and is regularly cultivated now in Japan. It's a very fast-growing, lightweight wood that has a beautiful tone. The bass koto is slightly larger. It's 17 strings and about 7 feet long, but it has a much deeper, richer sound that adds quite a lot to music and pieces in which it is played. We are all, including our guest musicians, dressed in kimono. Kimono must be fitting to the occasion and to the person's rank within the ensemble, their level of expertise. Sensei, as our leader and our teacher, is in the most formal black kurotone sode. And the men, of course, are wearing formal black male kimono with five crests. That's the highest level of formality in kimono. Men are also wearing hakama, which are the kind of overskirts or wide-legged divided pants that the men wear. Women wear them sometimes as well. None of us are wearing hakama today. We are all dressed in regular kimono. Some of the younger unmarried women are wearing furisode, which are the very colorful bright kimono with the very long sleeves and the fancy bows. As you get older and get married, kimono become less decorative, less elaborate. The bows are simpler, the designs are simpler, and our sleeves are shorter. They are no less beautiful, however. Wearing kimono is quite an honor. It's kind of fun, and it does lend, I think, quite a lot to the music for us to be dressed in traditional clothing rather than in Western clothing. We are setting up for our next piece, which is